Hi guys, this is Sushant Kochar. Today we are going to talk about why there is so much hype of not eating wheat and rice if you're into bodybuilding or fitness. So you might have come across this a lot of times that if you're trying to gain muscle, stop eating chapati, stop eating wheat, stop eating roti, it has gluten, it gets it sticks on your intestinal walls and it would not let you absorb the juices out of your food. And if you're on fat loss diet, stop eating wheat and rice, it will hamper your fat loss. You might have come across all of these things by now if you're into fitness or bodybuilding. See, in this video we are going to talk about where these sort of things, where this sort of misinformation originated. So, I have talked about this in my previous video, why there are so many myths in fitness industry. I would recommend that you go and watch it. So, we are going to discuss why there is so much of hype of not eating wheat and rice, not eating roti, chapati, phalke in the fitness and bodybuilding industry. See, people do not know a lot of things about fitness and bodybuilding. They would hear something from their gym trainer, they'll go to gym, they'll ask the gym trainer, they'll hear something from the gym trainer and they'll trust him. The trainer asks them to buy protein powder, they'll buy it. If the trainer says that only buy from me, they'll trust him and they'll only buy from him. They'll trust what the trainer says. So, and because they don't know anything, they'll just be working on the basis of trust. So, what happened is that bodybuilding, most of the bodybuilding came from foreign countries in India. So, bodybuilding, keeping big muscle sizes, abs, having muscular bodies, low body fat percentages, all this came majorly from countries outside India. Our sports were kushti, pehlwani, wrestling. These were our sports. You might not have seen the wrestlers in 1950s who were in the Indian wrestlers flaunting their abs or having lower body fat percentages. So it came from the Western countries. How did it come to our country? See, in the past few years, internet has played a great role. When you are sitting in India, you can watch someone's body in Africa or America. And before that, a lot of trainers in India would go to foreign countries to learn more, and they would come back and they would spread that knowledge that they gained from those countries. Okay, that could be a reason. So, foreigners do not, majority of the countries do not have chapati, the wheat chapati that we eat in India. They do not have it in their regular diet. Foreigners do not have it in their regular diet. Majority of them eat meat and eggs. So, what exactly must have happened, should have happened, is that they ate meat and eggs to build bodies. They didn't know what exactly was working in their body to give them muscle. So they thought, okay, this is a food that if eaten will give you a nice looking body, this food will give you muscles, because they didn't know how the foods were working inside their body. So they thought, okay, eating meat and eggs would give you the muscles. And so they didn't know exactly if there is anything else that can help you build muscle or not. They just thought it is a misconception inside people that they think that okay, eating this individual food item will help you build muscle, only eating this food item. So they would just stick to that item. So the foreigners didn't know exactly how it was working, and they were eating meat and eggs and they were gaining muscle. So so they told us that okay, eat meat and eggs, and they were not eating chapati, the wheat chapati. So they asked us to stop eating wheat and chapati and start eating meat and eggs. And they asked us to copy them, and unfortunately that is what a lot of Indians did. They stopped eating wheat and rice and started eating eggs and meat. people followed without giving any thoughts because they didn't know anything. They would trust whatever they were told. So the trainers in India were telling them what they learned from outside countries, and the people in India were believing what they were being told by the trainers. So basically, kind of the knowledge from the outside countries came to the people in bodybuilding in India, the trainers in India, and then the knowledge got spread to Indians because of those trainers. I would not say that it is strictly a fault of the trainers, because even they didn't know if they were being told right or wrong. They just trusted what they were being told.
Okay, now how would you prove that this not eating wheat and rice and eating non-veg to build muscle and lose fat is wrong? We have to prove this wrong. See, I'll give you four examples for this. Many people eat non-veg, they don't eat wheat and rice, go to gym, workout, and still they do not gain significant amount of muscle, or they do not lose significant amount of fat. Okay, you would say, okay, tell me something more. Now, science says there is no need to eat non-veg to build muscle. Science accepts this fact. And when you eat vegetarian, you are eating milk and milk products. But there are many vegans do not eat milk and milk products. There are many vegans who have shown that they have built great amount of muscle mass even on vegan diets, not even vegetarian, on vegan diets without having milk and milk products. You might have come across this on internet by now. Okay, you might say, okay, give me more proof. Then one of the biggest proof is Haryana, an Indian state. Haryana is on second number in the highest population of vegetarians. So the first number is from Rajasthan. So Rajasthan has around 75% vegetarian people, and then second comes Haryana, around 70% vegetarian people. Vegetarian culture, and you know, you must be knowing that a lot of wrestlers, boxers, bodybuilders, athletes are from Haryana, that represent India in international competitions. So a lot of strong people come out of Haryana, and Haryana has a predominantly vegetarian culture. It is on second number in India. Just pure milk and milk products and vegetarian diet. This is really strong proof. You might say, okay, I do not believe a survey of 10 people, 500 people, 1000 people, but you can definitely believe a survey of whole state. And the fourth one, science says that if you stop eating gluten, wheat, barley, rye, then it can have negative effect on your health, and it can cause diseases to you and your children or their children. So this proves that you should not stop wheat or gluten without any specific reason, like if you have any gluten related disease. And you should not eat non-veg just thinking that you have to eat non-veg to build muscle. There is no need to eat non-veg to build muscle. There is no need to stop wheat or rice to build muscle or lose fat. Okay, so basically this turns out to be false. This whole myth of eating non-veg to build muscle and stopping wheat and rice turns out to be false. Now, how this is harmless? See, it has spoiled our sattvic, high quality vegetarian culture in India, because people started eating non-veg. And when people start eating non-veg, a lot of times it is accompanied by alcohol. And these can lead, so consumption of alcohol can lead to crime. People might drink and come to their home and beat their wives. Maybe they run into a road accident, maybe they start fighting with others. So it can lead to crime. So as per Ayurveda, non-veg and alcohol, they both are not a part of good sattvic diet. Okay. And non-veg gives meat and eggs, gives a lot of diseases to people, and it is giving a lot of diseases to people. So you should not eat it. And when you stop eating gluten products like wheat, barley, rye, without any reason, just thinking that it should be stopped for bodybuilding and fitness purposes, you affected your health negatively, because you should not have quit eating highly nutritious foods like wheat, which has been eaten by our ancestors for hundreds of years. So these things are done by people doing bodybuilding, trying to cut down fat, gain muscle. But what others see is that, oh, this guy has low fat, and a lot of people think only having high fat is known as illness. So a lot of people think, okay, the person who has less fat is fit, even if that person has weak immune system. So for a lot of people, the definition of fitness is low fat, and bodybuilders keep low fat percentage. So people think, okay, this guy is fit, so we should follow what he is following, we should follow his diet. And bodybuilders stop eating wheat, rice, and start eating non-veg for the reasons I told you in the start. So the people thought that the definition of being fit is eating eggs and meat and stopping wheat and rice. So they molded the definition just by what they were observing. So you should not take this as a definition of fitness. Definitely not, because meat and eggs is a reason behind a lot of diseases, and stopping wheat can lead to bad health consequences. Now, in my previous videos, I've talked a lot about how it can be harmful if you stop eating gluten products. And I'm going to be talking about this in detail, why stopping eating chapati, wheat chapati, can be really harmful for you. I'm going to be making a detailed video. I've talked about decent detail in my previous videos as well, but I'm talking too much about this topic because I really don't want you to sacrifice your health. If you think that you're not concerned about your health, you would live your life your way, because it is one life, hashtag one life, and I would die my way. If you think so, that is your call, but at least think for your family, your loved ones, brother, sister, mother, father, children, your friends. At least think for your loved ones if you don't think for yourself. So if you think, okay, I'm making really long videos like 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 10 minutes, 7 minutes, I would say that spending 15 minutes watching a video and gaining some decent knowledge, which can save you from spending hours in queues at hospitals, is much better than spending. So basically, spending 15 minutes on the video is much better than spending hours in hospitals and then later going to doctors for multiple visits and then taking medication for weeks or months. It is much better to watch a 15 minute video than spending hours in the clinics and hospitals. So basically, I would say that I strongly recommend that you watch all the videos in my series of gluten and wheat related topics, even if you think that the videos are long. If you like this video, please like, comment, and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.